In this video, I'm going to talk about chemical hazards in the food. Hey, how are you doing today? This is Adib Irshad and you are watching Food Tech Simplified. If you are new to this channel, then I make simple and easy to understand lectures, videos and tutorials for the students like you who study food science and food technology. So if you want to level up your grades and simplify your studies, then make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell icon as well so that you don't miss my upcoming videos. Alright, so this is part 5 of the food safety series in which I'm going to talk about the chemical hazards in the food. If you haven't watched the earlier part 4, then I would recommend that please go and watch those parts first and then come over here to watch this one. I will link these 4 parts in the description down below. I have divided this video, this lecture into 3 different parts. First, I'm going to talk about the classification of the chemical hazards. Second, I'm going to talk about the sources of the chemical hazards. And then finally, I will talk about how you can prevent the chemical hazards from entering into your food. Okay, so now let's talk about the classification of the chemical hazards. Now, the chemical hazards are subcategorized into 3 categories. And the first one is the naturally present chemical hazards. Now, the naturally present chemical hazards are not added by some kind of human activity. They are naturally present in the food. What are the examples? The examples of the naturally present chemical hazards in the food are mycotoxins, scombotoxins, and mushroom toxins. Now, the mycotoxins are present in the milk. They could be present in the peanuts, in the soybeans, and some specific food products. The scombotoxins are present in the fishes. Now, these toxins can produce some kind of intoxication inside the human body if they are ingested. And these toxins are produced by some kind of bacteria or molds. The second subcategory is the directly added chemical hazards. Now, what are the directly added chemical hazards? If the additives like colorants, flavor enhancers, or preservatives are added in the food beyond the permitted limit, then what will happen? These preservatives or colorants or additives will impact or hamper the growth or hamper the system, the body of its consumer. Now, the third category of the chemical hazards in the food are indirectly added chemical hazards. Now, what are the indirectly added chemical hazards? The indirectly added chemical hazards involve pesticides and fertilizers that are involved in the agriculture and the cleaning agents like the sanitizers or the lubricants that are used in the machinery. Now, what could happen? The chemicals from these pesticides or the weedicides, fertilizers, and the chemical agents like sanitizers could enter into the food if it comes in contact with the crop or with some kind of food product. Alright, now I get the whole picture. What kind of picture? Do you remember that you did a video on biological hazards and you told that there are some toxins, toxicants, and you intake them and you will get intoxication? Now I get it. There are indirectly added and indirectly added, and if you intake them, you will get intoxication. Yes, I do remember I told in the biological hazards that if you intake some kind of toxins, you will get intoxication. But here I have talked about the toxicants. The naturally present chemical hazards are obviously the toxins that are produced by the microorganisms. And if you intake these naturally present chemical hazards, the toxins, you will get intoxication. But if you intake the additives, more additives than is required, and if you intake the chemicals that are present in the food from the pesticides, from the fertilizers, then you will not get any kind of food poisoning or food intoxication. Rather, you will get some kind of acute or chronic diseases, the long-term diseases. What are the long-term diseases? What are the chronic diseases? These are the diseases like cancer. Yeah, I know. Moving on to phase 2, and that is the sources of the chemical hazards in the food. The number one source is the waste material and the discharge from the industries. The second one is the use of poor agricultural practices. Now, what are the poor agricultural practices? Excessive use of the fertilizers and the pesticides are involved in the poor agricultural practices. The third source is the landfills near the crops or near the farms. And the fourth source is the vehicle emission, the emission and the pollution from the vehicles that enters into the food. Now, moving on to phase 3 and the final phase of this video, and that is the prevention of the chemical hazards in the food. Properly following and maintaining the good manufacturing practices in the food factory can lead to the prevention of the chemical hazards in the food. I have talked about the good manufacturing practices in my earlier videos, and if you want me to make a separate video on GMP, let me know and I'll make a separate video on good manufacturing practices. Basically, GMP involves and include the training of the workers and the employees. And it includes that you have to maintain the separate containers for the chemicals, for the toxic chemicals, and for the food. And you have to clean up the chemical residues or the lubricants or the sanitizing agents so that they don't come in contact with the food. The second way is our good old HACCP principle. Now, you'll be thinking that when I'm going to make a video on HACCP. Soon enough, now I'm going to make a video on HACCP principle. Now I have talked about all the hazards. Now I have talked about everything that is involved in the food safety. Now I will definitely make a video on the HACCP principle. So this was it for today. Let me know down in the comments if I have missed anything or if you have any kind of doubt. And if you want to level up your ways and simplify your studies, then make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell icon as well so that you don't miss my upcoming videos. Thank you. Class dismissed.